No, not at all. Neither he nor his advance team had any indication of what I was going to say in the introduction. And by the way, in my introduction, as you accurately noted, I did not say anything about cults or Mormonism or didn't mention Mitt Romney by name. All of this came about as a result of some reporters' questions after the introduction, in which one reporter asked me why I personally would not vote for a Mormon, and that's really what set all of this off.
So let me ask you, why did you even decide to bring this up now and bring up the issue of Mormonism and the fact that you believe that it's a cult? I mean, it was debated and discussed in 2008.
Right. Well, again, Kara, I'm not the one who brought it up. A reporter asked me, and, you know, my primary role is not of a politician or a pundit. I'm a pastor, and when somebody asks me a theological question about Mormonism, I have a responsibility to tell the truth. This is no surprise, as you said. I'm not a Jeremiah Wright on the fringe making fanatical statements. Mormonism has never been considered a part of evangelical historic Christianity. I believe Mitt Romney's a good, moral man. If it's a choice between Mitt Romney and the general election and Barack Obama,
but
I will vote for Mitt Romney.
But Pastor, I understand that you're saying that you responded to reporters, but you introduced Rick Perry. He's running for president of the United States. You're a supporter of his. And we asked Perry what he thought about what you said. This is what he told our reporters right after.
I wonder if you associated yourself with the comments of this way.
I answered your question. No, I don't think it is. Thank you all.
All right, now here's a man that you support. He's saying right there to reporters he doesn't agree with what you said with regard to Mormonism being a cult. So does this change your mind about him and how you feel about him?
Oh, not at all. Listen, there are plenty of reasons. I believe conservative evangelicals ought to vote for Rick Perry over Mitt Romney, and Mormonism is just one issue for evangelical Christians. But I think an equal issue is going to be Governor Romney's lack of consistency on some core issues to those of us who are evangelicals, like the abortion issue. I think many conservatives are suspect of his flip-flopping on that issue, and because of that, they have grave doubts about his suitability to be the conservative candidate for president.
All right. Romney, as you know, is a very successful businessman, since we're talking about issues now. He's been a CEO of a very successful company. In addition to running a state, many people believe he would be a very competent chief executive to run this nation in brutal economic times. So are you suggesting that religious beliefs should trump competence to be president?
Yes, to religious people, Kara, religion matters. And I'm a pastor. I was speaking to a group of conservative evangelicals, and I said in my introduction of Governor Perry, I certainly tout his economic platform, his success in Texas, but what I care about most as a Christian is his stance on biblical issues like the sanctity of life and the sanctity of marriage. And Governor Perry has a strong, long track record of being consistent. For example, he signed the Texas Sonogram Bill. He defunded Planned Parenthood. Those things are important to those of us who are evangelical Christians.
Understand, we know you support Rick Perry, but what does religion have to do with being a competent president? And I'm talking about specifically what you said about Mitt Romney.
Well, John Jay was the first Chief Justice of the United States Supreme Court, the author of the Federalist Papers, and he said, quote, "We have a duty and a privilege as Christians to select and prefer Christians as our leaders." I hardly think John Jay was a bigoted person. The fact is, those of us who are evangelicals have every right to prefer and select a competent Christian over a competent non-Christian. And again, Kara, it's not the only issue, but it's certainly one issue that we who are evangelicals are going to consider.
Let me throw something back at you then. Let's talk about Article 6, Paragraph 3 of the Constitution that says there's no religious test to being president. So are you going against the Constitution?
Kara, that is an outrageous statement. That refers to government cannot impose a litmus test. But as individual citizens, we have every right to impose a litmus test of the kind of person we prefer. I mean, is it bigoted to choose a conservative over a liberal or a liberal over conservative? You can show preference without being a bigot and certainly without violating the Constitution. The most simple constitutional student knows that Article 6 applies to government imposing no test. It has nothing to say about individuals having their own test.